Gemini. Welcome. It's me, Stella Wild, and I'm here with your October 2018 Intuitive Tarot reading. So I'm just going to get right into it. Anything you need to know about my readings, about my current product and course offerings, and my website will all be in the description. So I'm going to get right into it. Let me explain how I'm going to do the readings this month. I'm trying to make them a little bit shorter because I had to escape the hurricane and I was gone for 2 weeks and I just didn't have time until now, September 30th, to do the monthlies. So if you want, check out my weeklies. I do also weekly intuitive messages and you might enjoy those. I do them for each sign. So how I'm going to do your monthly, Gemini, is I'm going to pull three cards from my Rider-Waite deck and see what the general energy and message is for you. If I need to pull additional clarifiers, I will with either this deck or with my playing cards. At the end, I will wrap it all up with one spirit message card from the John Holland deck. I just got these cards right before the hurricane, and I have not had any time to really work with them, but they have messages at the bottom, so I'll read the message and then tie it all together with your cards, with your reading. Okay, Gemini, so let's see what's going on for you for the month of October 2018. Gemini. I like to shuffle and then pull from the middle of the deck. Let's see. One more. All right, Gemini, let's see. Okay, so you have the Hangman upside down, the Six of Cups upside down, and the Three of Pentacles. So what I'm getting from this is there's a childhood dream of that was not realized around some sort of writing and communication project, like writing a book, putting together a blog, making a book of poetry, but something literary, something to do with writing. And this month, you're going to be reconnecting with that childhood dream. The childhood dream to become a writer. I mean, Gemini is the third house. It is the house of writing. Geminis are about literary endeavors and communication, ruled by Mercury, as we know. So a lot of Geminis do have that natural gift of the gab, gift of writing. So very, gifted with words. So it's not that unusual that a Gemini would have a secret desire from a young age to write a book, write a diary, poems, whatever the case may be, a play. So this desire to be a writer is going to come to the fore again in October for you. And when I say writer, that of course means whatever, however that manifests for you, Gemini, right? It could even be songwriting. Who knows, right? This is a general reading. If you need a reading specific to your situation, check the link in the description. All right, so let's get serious. Back to this. So you've had a feeling, or you'll be having a feeling this month, Gemini, of not wanting to sacrifice that childhood dream any longer. That you've been postponing. You just keep saying, oh, I don't have time. I don't know. It just takes so much time to write. I don't have time. And something is going to come along. I'm going to pull a clarifier. That's going to change that situation for you. You are not going this month to be settling for this sacrifice any longer. You are finally this month going to put your creative dreams back on the priority list. And it is highly possible that you end up taking some sort or signing up. If you don't start it this month of October, maybe you start it in November or you're going to start it next year. But you sign up for it now, or you start saving the money for it now to take some sort of writing class, whether that's online, in your community, whatever the case may be. You may be even involved with getting a writing group together this month. You start meeting at a coffee shop or in each other's homes, something like that. So literary endeavors that this desire that was rooted in your childhood dreams, you're going to be paying attention to it this month, Gemini, because of this feeling that you've been sacrificing that side of you. You have not been paying attention to it. And Geminis are so talented in this area that it is a shame that if you have that childhood dream that you don't manifest it, that you don't put the time in to enjoy that. So let's see. I'm going to pull. Do I want this or I want the other one? No, I need one of these. All right, let me see. Let me see what else you need to know. Okay. So there has been, or there will be this month, there's two possible ways I'm hearing this. I'm hearing it as there will be a heartbreak that needs to be processed, and that's the catalyst for you to a love, not just, oh my, you know, my dog died, which is horrible, right? Horrible. Been through that. Know what that's like. I'm feeling this is more relationship. Not that our pets aren't relationship material, but you know what I'm saying. We love our pets so much. There's a heartbreak you're going to have to process. I'm feeling it's going to be a fresh heartbreak since this came up. But it can also, so it can be a literal heartbreak that you're going to want to write about this relationship that has ended. Okay, so that's what I'm saying. Like, that's the catalyst for this new creative endeavor, for this book that you want to create. Or my other thing that I was hearing is that somebody's been making you feel bad for wanting to have this dream. And that could even be a feeling, because this is upside down, the Six of Cups. That could even be from your childhood. So somebody could have been giving you the message that you can't do this, or it's frivolous to want to go write a book. Writers don't make any money. You know, all that spiel that you get from people. And that could have been those fears, you know, that we get, the inner critic that we get as writers, that can be coming to the fore. But you're going to say to yourself, Gemini, I am not going to allow these things, these leftover tapes from childhood where they say, no, you can't do that. You're not good enough. You can't do it. Writers don't make money. La, la, la. You're going to say, I'm done with that. I am tired of sacrificing myself. I don't want to have this painful regret that I am not pursuing my creative dreams. And this has been coming up for you, actually, for the last couple of months that I've been doing these readings. So you might even want to go back and look at July, I think there was one that was like that. So this seems to be a theme for you lately, Gemini, about this idea of connecting with your creative energy and connecting with other like-minded individuals. I feel you're also going to, because of this Three of Swords, look, three here, three here, you're going to be changing your associations, changing the groups that you are hanging out with, because you want to be around like-minded and supportive people with these literary endeavors. Because let's face it, not everybody gets it. Hey, I've been a writer since I was 6 years old, and I know people don't always get it. But, and so you don't want the heartbreak of hanging around with people who don't get it and discount it and poo-poo it or shame you for it or try to shame you or make you feel bad about how you want to stay home and work on your project instead of going out with them, whatever the case may be. All right, so you're done with that. You're done with the sacrificing of that. Okay, that is beautiful. All right, I'm going to pull a couple playing cards for you, and let's see, Gemini. So this month of October, you're really reconnecting with that. And there could be, like I said, with that Three of Swords, there could be some sort of processing around a romantic relationship that needs to happen. And you want to do it through art. You want to process that through your writing. All right, let's see what we got here. Wow. This is interesting. If you can, all right, I'm hearing two things. I'm getting two things about this for you. The thing about writing is that you have to be able to, the success really comes from being able to just sit your butt in the chair and write. I read an article once that called it the talent of the room, that's what you really need to succeed as a writer. I forget the writer's name now who wrote that article, but it's really good. You need the talent of the room to be able to sit your butt in the chair and do the writing. Why am I saying this? Because look, you have the home card, you have the union or marriage card, and the popularity card. If you can make yourself one, if you can marry your home, right, with your butt in the chair, you have a very good chance of having your creative endeavor become popular. Okay. Now there's another interpretation to this. I said before, maybe you're going to have a writing group, artistic group in your home. And that would be a really good use of this energy as well. So uniting this Ten of Hearts is not just about marriage. It's uniting with other people for a common purpose. So it's very similar to this Three of Pentacles. So, and this is the home card, and this is popularity card. So if you open up your home to other people, like-minded individuals, and you have a writing group, a writing gathering, you're going to really feel good about that. You're going to become a popular person in that group, and you're going to be able to support each other with your endeavors, and it's going to be very satisfactory for everyone involved. And getting that feedback from like-minded people is going to really help your writing, and again could lead it to reaching a lot of people, having it become very popular. So that's very cool. So it's really about honoring your creative desires and not sacrificing and doing for everybody else. And yeah, I think it's good. I'm gonna pull one more. I want to keep these to about 16 minutes. I want to pull one more tarot card for you. I feel like you need it. What else does Gemini need to know about this situation? Okay, Queen of Wands. So of course this is fire sign energy, but the Queen of Wands, this is all about, whether you're male or female watching this, this is about using your creativity and your intuition and going for it. So this month of October, Gemini, you are going to be stepping into that creative power and not letting anything stop you. So you want to really hold on to that energy. Because you're done. I mean, you're tired of sacrificing. You just feel like time is passing you by. And with that hangman upside down that we had, it's the time is over. The waiting is over. It's time. It's time, Gemini. All right, let's see what your spirit message card is. What is Gemini's spirit message? What is Gemini's spirit message? Oh, I love this. What you got? You got have fun. And look, there's two on here. The twins, Gemini. Have fun. Stop. When was the last time you had fun? When was the last time you took a chance and did something silly, something totally unlike you? Something just for the joy of it, which is about your creative endeavor. It's long overdue for you to let go of your analytical mind and give yourself and your soul permission to have fun. So My goodness, with this Queen of Wands energy also, it is time to unite with others. Because look, you're not alone here. You're with other people. Unite with others and support each other and have fun in doing your creative endeavor, your writing, your playwriting. Maybe it's even a drama group, right? But it's something involving the literary arts. And it's something you've been wanting to do for quite a while. And this is the month to do it, Gemini. To have fun with it, the waiting is over. All right. I wish you all the best, Gemini. I hope you enjoyed the video. Like, share, subscribe. And I will see you next month. Okay, I hope you have a good one. Take care. Bye-bye.